Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. So in today's lecture we're going to see how to design a Butterworth bandpass filter. Previously we already designed a Butterworth low pass filter, high pass filter, then we designed the Chebyshev type first filter. Now this is the third video which is based on a filter, so is a Butterworth bandpass filter. So now we can start the actual programming. So firstly I have taken clear all command to clear all whatever the command window, whatever the history which are present in a command, so that all data will be clear. Now next, now I can take attenuation, passband attenuation. So for that I can write alpha p is equal to 2, then I can write alpha s is equal to 20, then I can write, so basically in bandpass filter we require two passband frequency and two stopband frequency, basically from 0 to some frequency we have to stop that band, then from that we have to pass to a fixed frequency, means at the end of the frequency, and after that end frequency we have to stop that frequency. So basically we required two stop band, two pass band frequency. So firstly indirectly I can write whatever the frequency in matrix form, like 0.2 into pi, this is the first frequency. Second frequency I can take 0.4 into pi, I can complete the square bracket. So these are the two passband frequency, 0.2 into pi, this is the first passband frequency, and 0.4 into pi is the second passband frequency. Now I can write stopband frequency is equal to, again in square bracket, again I can take two stopband frequency, first one is a 0.1 into pi, comma, second one 0.5 into pi. Now if you observe both passband and stopband frequency, then you can understand. So first one is a lowest frequency, that is a 0.1 into pi, so this is the first frequency. So basically for whatever the first frequency, that should be a stop, so that is nothing but 0.1 pi. After that whatever the frequency is there, means from 0.2 to 0.4, whatever the frequency between them, that frequency should be passed. So that is nothing but pass frequency, and after that whatever the frequency is there, that should be a stop. So after the 0.5 into pi, that frequency should be a stop band frequency. So this is a overall whatever we have taken a pass band frequency and stop band frequency. Now again you can give the comment for both for each and every line. This is nothing but pass band attenuation, basically the same dB. In the same way you can write, this is a pass band, sorry, this is a stop band attenuation in dB, and this is nothing but pass band frequency in radians, and this is nothing but stop band frequency in radians. So now the next one, now find cutoff frequency and order of the filter. Now the next thing is we have to find out whatever the cutoff frequency and the order of the filter. So for that you can directly write the function, that is n comma omega n is equal to. So through this command you can find out whatever the cutoff frequency and order of the filter, that is nothing but b u double t o r d, so is nothing but order of the Butterworth filter. In bracket you can write whatever passband frequency divided by pi. So this is the frequency I have taken in a digital form, then ws divided by pi comma, then attenuation, that is alpha p comma alpha s. Just complete the bracket. Now next, now you can find out the whatever the function means, transfer function. So for that you have to write a system function of the filter. So for that you can find out the coefficient like b comma a bracket complete equal to. So how to find out the basic system function? Let's just take the butter, that is a Butterworth filter command, butter, that is n comma, if I take the butter of the order function, so in that case you will get a whatever the system function. Then you can find out, for example, you can take a frequency omega is equal to 0s to 0.01s to pi. Now I can convert whatever the function is there, that should be in a z domain form. Basically in this form the function is in the s domain, then you have to convert into the z domain, because we have to find out the zero and pole, because that whatever the stability is depends upon the zero and pole of the Butterworth filter. So that's why we have to convert into s domain to z domain. So you can write, that is h comma ph, for example we have taken that ph is equal to, you can write a command frequency, sorry, is equal to frequency 0. So it will find out the h of z function. So in that you can write that h of z function of, or frequency z function of this particular coefficient b comma a comma frequency omega. Now next thing, we have to convert whatever that frequency into the dB. So you can write 20 into log of 10 in bracket absolute of h. So in this case it will convert whatever the frequency z, or that frequency should be in a dB form. So that's why we have multiply by 20 log of 10. Then I can find out whatever the angle, that is nothing but phase of h. So you will get a phase. Now I can plot the final case, is nothing but subplot. So now I can take two rows, one column, location first, then I can plot a signal, that is a ph divided by phi comma m. So through this you will get whatever the x axis is a ph divided by pi. Ph is nothing but we have taken a frequency z component divided by pi comma m. M is nothing but this frequency that we have taken in a dB form. So you will get a magnitude response for that. Then I can take a grid on. The grid on is nothing but like your graph paper, whatever the dotted line, horizontal line, vertical lines. Then after grid on, you can take x label. X label is a basically normalized frequency. Y label is nothing but gain in dB. Then again I can plot what is the phase response. So for that I can take 2 comma, these two rows, first column location second. Again I can write plot, again ph divided by par, comma, now the an. An is nothing but angle of that Butterworth filter, so that is nothing but phase, that is an. Again I can take grid on, and then again I can take x label. Again x label you can write normalized frequency. Now I have to change y label. Now y label is angle, or you can write phase in radians. Okay, now this is all the program for a Butterworth bandpass filter. So basically first we have taken a clear all command to clear whatever the history present in a MATLAB. So then we have taken a attenuation, that is a passband attenuation in a dB to stopband attenuation 20. Then we have taken a two passband frequency and two stopband frequency, because in a bandpass filter basically we require the signal should be stop, then pass, and then should be a stop. So there are two passband frequency and two stopband frequency. Then we have taken a cutoff frequency, and that's order of the filter. So by using a butturd command you can find out the order of the filter. Then as per the order you can find out the system function in a S domain, so that is nothing but B comma A, you will get a system function. Then I have taken one frequency, then I have taken one command, frequency Z. So through this command you can convert whatever the system function into the Z domain, like H of Z function. Then I have taken a whatever the frequency, that is a frequency domain signal, that is H of Z signal, I have find out the absolute value of that. Then I have taken an is equal to angle, so it will find out the phase, that is nothing but angle of that frequency Z function. Then simply I have taken subplot, then I have taken a plot of that absolute value, grid on for vertical horizontal dotted lines, x label, y label, again subplot, here again is one of the plot, here I have taken a phase, simply x label, y label. Now just go to the run option, click on run. Now if you see the graph, now you can see from this point to this point basically is a that whatever the signal is there, that signal is have the stop band up to that point 2, after that point 2 to point 4 have a pass band, and after point 4 or after that point 4 to or max point for after 0.5 we have a stop band. So how this possible? So this is very simple. If I check, it's a 0.2 pi, up to this point we have a stop band 0 to 0.4 into pi, up to this point is 0.2 to 0.4 we have a pass band, and we have a 0.1 into pi have a stop band, means up to 0.1 we have a stop band, and up to 0.5 means after 0.5 we have a stop band. Okay, so this is basic design of bandpass Butterworth bandpass filter. So this is a whatever the frequency Z function in a absolute value form, and this is in a, means basically is a magnitude response of that, and this is nothing but phase response. If you want to take a printout of this, so in that case just go to the edit option. In edit we have a figure properties, just click on the figure properties, it will open the one window. So like this, in that just click on the figure color, just select the white background, okay, and after that just go to the print and you can take a printout. So this is a easy way to take a printout from MATLAB software. Now I hope you understand how to design a Butterworth bandpass filter. So this type of filters are very much important in any designing, like if you want to process any signal, any speech signal or any signal, in that case basically we required this type of filter. So I hope this video will be useful for you in any study. So thank you. So those who have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe, like my channel and also share my channel. Thank you.